The Yolo Bypass was a historical floodplain. Today, it is a resource for people, habitat for fish and wildlife, and flood protection is the primary purpose of the Yolo Bypass today. It's 59,000 acres. It's a pretty large piece of land. It's 40 miles long, about 3 miles wide on average. It collects probably 80% of the floodwaters and diverts them into the bypass, protecting the city of Sacramento and the surrounding areas. We have a lot of agriculture in the bypass, a lot of rice. We have hunting in the bypass, duck clubs. It is a Pacific flyway hub for waterfowl and the shorebirds. It's a fisheries habitat, so it's pretty important.
The Yolo Bypass is not only a prominent element of the Sacramento area flood control system, it's an important fish migration corridor. The Fremont Weir allows for high flows from the Sacramento River onto the bypass, which occurs in about 1 out of 2 or 3 years. When water spills over the Fremont Weir, adult salmon, steelhead, and sturgeon, on their way upstream, are often attracted into the Yolo Bypass. When the Sacramento River falls back down below the top of the weir, fish become stranded downstream of this large concrete wall. These fish that have traveled almost 40 miles end up disconnected from the river.
This project focuses on updating the old Daniil fish passage ladder. The problem was when the fish get to the structure, there's inadequate depth for them to pass through the old structure, which was just 4 feet wide and 6 feet deep. So the fish passageway channel now widens that to 15 feet wide and 10 feet deep. The whole system's automated, and once the water levels get high enough to overflow Fremont Weir, the gate is triggered to open and allow fish to return back to the Sacramento River. And that connection improves fish passage and reduces their likely to get stranded in the Yolo Bypass and at Fremont Weir.
From a fish's perspective, when Yolo Bypass floods, the bypass is the river. So a fish coming up the bypass when it's flooding is moving up towards its spawning grounds. But as the river starts to drop and the water drops below the crest of that weir, suddenly that water turns off. And where all the fish would have been attracted up the Yolo Bypass towards Fremont Weir, suddenly they're stuck. And we needed a way to keep enough water moving through that weir to allow the fish back to the river, to attract them to that place and put them back where we want them, instead of having them stray into drainage canals and die. And losing an adult winter run, a fish that's on the brink of extinction, is unbearable. This is a fish that has made it out to the ocean. It's almost back. It's almost there to reproduce, to have 5,000 eggs in the gravel, and we're losing it because it is attracted to ag flow. If a fish or any other native critter can't recognize the river system, the habitat that they're adapted to, then they're not gonna do well. So our job is to understand how the valley used to work, what fish expect, and be able to mimic that, to work with nature to allow salmon to recognize the Sacramento River again.
This project is a prime example of what we can do when state and federal partners work with local government and landowners for the benefit of fish and water supply reliability in California. It's a big win to have this project completed, and we've learned a lot through the implementation of the Adult Fish Passage Project, and we'll continue to use that knowledge as we move forward on future efforts to address adult fish passage barriers and juvenile floodplain rearing habitat.
The Department of Water Resources and the U.S. Bureau of Reclamation have a large suite of actions that we need to implement in order to help the recovery of these species. The overall mission is to promote recovery so that we are not causing jeopardy of any of these species when we operate the State Water Project or the Central Valley Project. That's the ultimate goal. We have a long way to go still, and within the bypass, there are several fisheries issues that we need to address as well, but this is a really good start.